don't tell a drink at every skeleton.
He's holding on to the six of spades, so I guess he thinks you want it. That last draw was the eight of hearts. He needs kings and queens. Who are you?
Bond. James Bond.
Come on, come on. Ah, that's more like it.
What's your name?
Jill.
Jill who?
Jill Masterson.
Tell me, Jill, why does he do it?
He likes to win.
Why do you do it?
He pays me.
Is that all he pays you for?
And for being seen with him.
Just seen?
Just seen.
I'm so glad. You're much too nice to be mixed up in anything like this. Now, hear this, Goldfinger. Your luck has just changed. I doubt very much if the Miami Beach police would take kindly to what you're doing. Nod your head if you agree. Nod. Good. Now start losing, Goldfinger. Shall we say, $10,000? No, let's be generous. Let's make it $15,000.
May I see?
Well, I can see this is really my day. Jen.
Oh.
Hello.
Aren't you in the wrong room, Mr. Bond?
Not from where I'm standing.
Since you are here, would you mind giving me something to put on? Anyway, I'm very glad to see you again, Mr. Bond.
I'm glad to see you again.
And why are your socks inside out?
Because socks are badly designed. The seams are on the inside, hurt the toes. In some cultures, it's considered good luck to be wearing something inside out.
And you believe that?
No, but it's like praying. What do you risk? And I do go outside. How do you think those windows get clean? Now, about this professor of yours. How did it feel having him tell you what you can't do?
Like he knew he was better than me.
Then let's show him what you can do. Why is it the words we write for ourselves are always so much better than the words we write for others? Move. Sit. Go ahead.
Go ahead and what?
Write.
What are you doing?
I'm writing. Like you'll be when you start punching those keys.
Is there a problem?
No, I'm just thinking.
No. No thinking. That comes later. You write your first draft with your heart. And you rewrite with your head. The first key to writing is to write.
You benighted mockers! We're gonna teach you soldiering, the world's noblest profession. When we've done with you, you'll be able to stand up and slaughter your enemies like civilized men. But first, you'll have to learn to march in step, do the manual of arms, without even having to think. Good soldiers don't think, they just obey. Do you suppose if a man thought twice, he'd give his life for queen and country? Not bloody likely. He wouldn't go near the battlefield. One look at your foolish faces tells me you're going to be crack troops. Or him there with a 5 1/2 hat size has the makings of a bloody hero. I knew it. We're in one of the greatest libraries in all of Christendom.
How are we going to find the book we're looking for?
In time. Ah, the Beatus of Lebanon. That, Hanzo, is a masterpiece. And this is the version annotated by Umberto de Bologna. How many more rules? How many more books? No one should be forbidden to consult these books.
The ruins of old Ireland, how wondrously they stand, by the lakes and rushing rivers on the hilltops of our land.
Around these walls of battle, the Viking and the Dane, the Norman and the Saxon and the Cavaliers of Spain.
It makes a man feel like the lord of the castle. I wonder now, is it the Danes or the Vikings swarming up the valley to storm the fort?
The Danes.
We'll both be put to the sword.
But before we are, you would crave the favor of one last kiss.
Mr. McBride, I thought you could do better than that.
Maybe I could.
Penic erection was one of the many unsolved evolutionary mysteries surrounding sexuality. Every society had an elaborate subculture devoted to erotic stimulation. But nobody could quite determine how this becomes this. Of course, we all know the physical process involved, but not the link between stimulus and response. There seems to be a correlation with violence, with fear. Many hanged men died with an erection. You are all more or less aware of our intensive researches into this subject. Sexuality declined, probably because we no longer needed to procreate. Eternals soon discovered that erection was impossible to achieve. And we are no longer victims of this violent, convulsive act, which so debased women and betrayed men. This brutal, like other primates living unselfconscious lives, is capable of spontaneous and reflexive erection. As part of May's studies of this creature, we are trying to find once again the link between erotic stimulation and erection. This experiment will measure autoerotic stimulation of the cortex leading to erection. Play. Tracer indicates that this image is not erotically stimulating to the brutal. Change.
This doesn't seem to affect him either. Swella's done the trick herself.
Pussy.
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 You said you wanted to know how to get Capone. Do you really want to get him? You see what I'm saying? What are you prepared to do?
Everything within the law.
And then what are you prepared to do? If you open the ball on these people, Mr. Nash, you must be prepared to go all the way. Because they won't give up the fight until one of you is dead.
I want to get Capone. I don't know how to get him.
Want to get Capone? Here's how you get him. He pulls a knife, you pull a gun. He sends one of yours to the hospital, you send one of his to the morgue. That's the Chicago way. And that's how you get Capone.
Sir?
Hancock, I've got lunatics laughing at me from the woods. My original plan has been scuppered now that the jeeps haven't arrived. My communications have completely broken down. Do you really believe that any of that can be helped by a cup of tea?
Couldn't hear it, sir.
Yes, my lord.
I ordered you to take this castle.
Yes, my lord.
Well, take it. Bring it down and get my statue.
They surrender, and your statue is a rock.
I want it done.
There is no treasure.
Do it.
There are no soldiers in there, just some children and the mad old man.
And what is that to me?
And it should mean something.
Is that disapproval, Robin? Am I in the wrong?
I followed you for 20 years. I fought for you in the Crusades. I fought for you here in France. Show me a soldier and I'll fight him now. But I won't slaughter children for a piece of gold that never was.
I ordered it. I command you.
You do it! You're a bloody bastard. You'll enjoy it.
Damn right I'll do it. Now, carry on!
Sire!
Arrest those two! Lock them up! I'll have their heads on!
You cannot die, MacLeod.
accepted.
Hate you.
Good. That is a perfect way to start.
Tell me, how did it happen, for God's sake?
Why does the sun come up? Or are the stars just pinholes in the curtain of night? Who knows? What I do know is that because you were born different, men will fear you, try to drive you away, like the people of your village. You must learn to conceal your special gift and harness your power until the time of the gathering.
What gathering?
When only a few of us are left, we will feel an irresistible pull towards a faraway land to fight for the prize. Suddenly remembered my Charlemagne. Let my armies be the rocks and the trees and the birds in the sky.